Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we're working on a open a ticket contacts menu. So if we right click on the user, let's go to apps and let's click open a ticket. And a ticket has been opened. It says wind opened a ticket for Python bot. If we try to create another ticket, it says that a ticket has already been opened. I can also create a ticket for myself by right clicking on my name, going to apps and clicking open a ticket. And it says, I've opened a ticket for wind at this ticket. And it says, wind, open a ticket for wind. Okay, now let's go to the documentation. This is the documentation for tree.contextMenu. So our name will be open a ticket. And then we can specify our guild or guilds if you want to make the context menu guild specific. There are two ways you can specify a guild. You could either use the guild or guilds parameter here, or you could use the decorator. I'll show you both. And to specify the type of context menu, like a member or a message context menu, you just specify here either message or user. Okay, now let's go to our code. Okay, now let's create our context menu. So our context menu is called open a ticket, and its guild is our testing server. And then we have our interaction, and then we have our member. There's another way you could specify the guild. You could use @appcommands.guilds. Okay, so you could either use this guild parameter here, or you could use the decorator @appcommands.guilds and then specify your Discord object. But you have to make sure that this argument, this decorator, is below the like this first line. Okay, now let's actually work on the callback. Okay, so we'll be using the code that we use for our open a ticket button, and except we're just going to modify a little bit. We're going to add a defer. And then we want to change interaction.user to user. Okay, I changed interaction.user to user. So one more thing, for your utils.get, what you want to do is you want to lowercase the name and then replace the space with a dash, because Discord converts spaces to dashes. And if you don't do this, then the utils.get will search for a ticket that will never exist. So it's important that you do this. I've also done this for the button. So make sure you do interaction.user.name.lower and then replace the space with a dash. Okay, now we're ready to run our code. Okay, now let's go to Discord. Let's close these tickets. Okay, now let's try to open another ticket via the context menu. So we go to apps, I go to open a ticket, and it says I've opened a ticket for wind. Let's do it again. And it says it already has a ticket open. Let's go to the ticket. It says wind created a ticket for wind. Let's try to create a ticket for the bot. It says I've opened a ticket. And let's try to create another ticket. And it says that there's already a ticket. Okay, this is it for this episode. In the next episodes, we'll be working on button cooldowns, permissions checks, and then we'll wrap up the series. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. The link is on screen. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It'll really help out the channel. Thank you for watching.